children, how are you all? Oh, it's good to know you all are fine. That's good. Must take care of yourselves. Yes? That's nice. Now, let us start with a interesting chapter in grammar. Yes, the chapter is chapter 9 and it's about a, an and the. The use, how and when we are going to use a, an and the in our sentences. So, ready to learn? Let's start. Yes. The alphabets. Yes, the alphabets A, E, I, O, U. Yeah, these are the few alphabets which is taken from the alphabet, full alphabet, and they are known as the vowels. What are they known as? Vowels. Yes, which are they? Let us repeat again. A, you can repeat with me. Yes. A, E, I, O, U. These are the alphabets which are called as, known as vowels. And the rest of the alphabets. Okay, there are 27 alphabets. Yes. There are 27 alphabets and out of that, these are the vowels and the rest of them are known as, all other letters are called consonants. All other letters in the alphabet are known as consonants. Okay, so why is this A, E, I, O, U different? Let us see and understand. Yes, how to use A and N. We use a before a consonant sound and we use n before a vowel sound. Yes? Okay. Usage. Yes? Used before words beginning with the consonant sound. Where, what? A. Yes? A man. Yes? So, as I had told you, A, E, I, O, U, they are vowels. So, ma, men is having ma sound. So, that is not a vowel. Yes, that is not a vowel. And so, we are going to use a before men. Then, a lamb. Yes, again it is starting with L, L. So, again, A, we are going to use a lamb. Cat. So, again, it's not a vowel and so it's a consonant and so we are going to use a before cat. A cat. Yes. Now, let us see about our vowels. Yes. Used before words that begin with vowel sound. A, an. Yes. Whenever a letter, a word is starting with the sound of vowels, then we are going to use an. For example, an apple, a, an eraser, e, an umbrella, a, yes? So, these words are not only beginning with the letters A, E, U, but they have sound also of vowels. They have vowel sound. Yes? Is it clear? Are you understanding? Yes? Let's see next. Yes. Remember, this is a very important note for this chapter. Very important to remember. Yes, and it will be very easy for y'all to know whether you will write a or an before a particular word. It is sound that is important, not the spelling. So, we are going to be very careful that just we see the spelling and we don't write a or an. We will speak the word and we will understand the sound and then we will say write a or an. Yes. See here now. A tricky one. Yes. Let's see. We say an r, not a r. Yes. Why? The spelling is starting with h. No. H is a consonant. Why? Because the h in r. Yes. The h, we don't say har and har. Yes, we don't say like that. It's wrong. Yes, we don't pronounce it as an R. We say an R. R. So, it is pronounced. The H in R is not pronounced. Yes, when we speak R, you can listen a sound. Yes, but we don't say har. So the H in the word R is not pronounced. So the word begins with a vowel sound. Yes, R, a, a. When we speak, what we can listen is to the sound, and the sound is the vowel sound. And so we, instead of using a R, we use an R. Yes, very good. Yes, same way we say a uniform, not an uniform. Yes, why? Because the U in this word has a consonant sound. Yes, ear sound. When you say uniform, ear. Yes, so the U is having the ear sound, and Y is not a vowel, and so we are going to use an uniform. Yes, we are going to use an, not an uniform, but a uniform. Yes, not an uniform. Is it clear? Yes, fine. These are the few places where we have to be careful in using a and an. Okay. Indefinite articles. What are a and an? They are articles. They are known as articles. Using a or an depends on the sound that that begins the next word. So, a plus singular noun begins with a consonant. A boy, a car, a bike, a zoo, a dog. Yes, they all are having a consonant sound. And so, we are going to insert the indefinite article, that is a. But an plus singular noun begins with a vowel. For example, an elephant, an egg, an apple, an idiot, an orphan. So, all these are having a vowel sound. And so, in we are going to use an before these words. Yes? Okay. We use a or an when we talk about a person or thing for the first time. We don't know which particular person or thing we are talking about. So, we will use indefinite articles that are a or an. Yes? We use a or an when it is not clear which person or thing we mean. A or an is often used to mean any. It can be any. Okay, if I want something and I want one of the students to bring something to me, I will say, send one girl, send a girl to me. I want her to write a poem. So, a, yes. But when I say particularly, send Smita to me. Yes, so I particularly mean Smita. So, that time I am not going to use a or an. Yes, so we also use a or an to mean one. We can use a or an to mean one. When there is more than one, we are not going to use the articles a and an. We use the when it is clear which person or thing we mean. Whenever we want to talk about a particular person or thing, we will start using the article the. Okay, we start using the article the. For example, a woman is standing there. We don't know which woman. Look at the woman standing there. We know which woman. The word standing there tells us which woman. Now we know that we are pointing, standing there. That means we are talking about particularly one woman. Yes, we are talking about someone who is standing there, maybe under the tree, which we are pointing. Yes, so now we particularly know which lady, which person, which woman we are talking about. And so, we will use the. The indicates particularly and clearly about whom we are talking. Yes? There are two kinds of articles. Definite article, that is the. The makes us very clear and we are sure about which person or thing we are talking about. But there is another indefinite articles. They are a and an. Yes? And so, when an object is being introduced for the first time, we use an indefinite article a or an before it. It will always come before the person or thing we are talking about. Yes, before the word, before the noun. Yes, after the object has been introduced, we then use definite article the to talk about it. Once we have introduced the article or thing, then we start, instead of a and an, we start using the definite article the, when we are clear and we know about whom we are talking. Yes. Okay, let us see a few examples, and now it should be quite clear to you. You will understand it easily. Yes, let's revise. We waited for an hour. Yes, because it is having a vowel sound. So we will not see H and directly write a, or directly say or speak a. We are going to listen and remember the sound. Yes, H is silent here, and so an R. Yes, then please give me a pen. Yes, P, pen. It's a consonant, and so we write the article a, and we are talking about one pen. Yes, I have bought a bag and an umbrella. I paid rupees 180 for the bag and rupees 90 for the umbrella. Now, first of all, when I started speaking about umbrella and bag, I said a bag and umbrella. Why? Because it can be any bag, any umbrella. But now once I have bought and I'm sure that I'm talking about this particular bag, then I start using the article the. Yes, because we know for sure I'm not talking about any other bag, I'm talking about the yellow color bag which I have bought, and so I'm sure about it. I have paid 180 rupees for the bag, and so once I'm sure about what I have in with me or I'm talking about, I start using the article, or we start using the article the. Yes, is it clear, children? And for the same thing I do for the umbrella also. Yes, I have bought an umbrella also with it, and so I'm going to use the for the bag and umbrella. Yes, so this is how you can make use of the articles, that is a and the. Yes, bye children.